Namaskar. It's been 3 years since the NDA government led by Prime Minister Narendra Modi has taken office, and this gives us an opportunity to go and speak to each ministry and find out what really has been achieved in these last 3 years. And we're very privileged to have with us Mr. D.V. Sadananda Gowda, the Minister for Statistics and Program Implementation. Thank you very much, sir, for being with us. First of all, this ministry has two wings, statistics and program implementation. If we take the statistics part first, you provide statistics on so many different fields, economy, health indicators, social indicators. But, you know, people remember GDP, IIP, inflation. In the last 3 years, how have these figures, you know, how have you worked out these figures, sir?
So we wanted to have more transparent in all our activities, including the measurement of GDP, IIP, and the consumer price index. All those things are made very transparent nowadays by using modern technologies and all that. Of course, to make it very clear to people of the country, the base year for the national accounts has been revised because the structure of our economy has changed nowadays. Right. So the base year has been changed from 2004-05 to 2011-12. Even to get more data, we are making use of the corporate data from the Ministry of Corporate Affairs, so that we are getting more feedback while calculating the GDP. Similarly, the national survey, national sample survey which we are conducting, has given us a full feedback where we are making use of national sample surveys also while calculating the GDP. This unemployment survey, employment surveys, all these things has given a clarity in calculation of GDP nowadays.
Actually, international organizations also provide GDP figures. To what extent are these aligned with our figures, or how do they use government data at all, sir?
Certainly, because we are following the United Nations guidelines, and we have got our own experts team who will provide us some feedback how the GDP need to be calculated. So time and again, when there are discussions in the international forum also, these GDPs are calculated, and the mode of calculations and other things are taken into consideration. So there is very much clarity as far as the calculation of GDP is concerned. Our government has already, the cabinet has approved the United Nations guidelines, so that it gives us more clarity in the international scenario as far as GDP is concerned.
We are a federal structure, so obviously there is the center and the states, and you are the nodal ministry, and then we have panchayat level, etc. How does this information come from there up to your nodal ministry, and how does it go back?
See, practically there are two types of getting data. At the central level, it is laterally, it has been decentralized between the ministries as well as the government. And we are getting all this data from the various ministries also. Similarly, in the lower level, in the state level, it is vertically decentralized, right from the state up to the district and the lower level up to your panchayats and even to the local bodies. So in the central, laterally, it has been decentralized. In the state level, vertically, it has been decentralized from the panchayats through district authority. The state will get the data. From there, state will send the data to the nodal ministries at the center.
So what have been some of the key achievements of the Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation over the last 3 years?
Practically, we had several achievements since last 3 years. We have concluded our sixth economic census. The results of sixth economic census were released in March 2016, and wherein a clear picture of the establishment establishments employing more than 10 and more workers has been clearly indicated, and this data has been given to the public domain as well as to the states, so that they can take up further issues as far as these establishments are concerned. Similarly, GDP base year has been revised, as I rightly already said, 2004-05 to 2011-12. Even consumer price index also, we have revised the base year from 2012 that equal to 100. That means incorporating the methodological changes in the measurement of index and consumer basket in connection with the international practices. We have adopted the United Nations Fundamental Principles of Official Statistics through a cabinet approval. One of the important areas that we have started our survey, that is periodic labor force survey. It has been launched by the ministry on April 2007, last month itself we have done it, with the primary objective to measure the quarterly changes of various statistical indicators of the labor market in urban areas and generate annual estimate different labor force indicators both in rural and urban. Certainly, we have a web-based developed a computer-assisted personal interviewing system solution to use this for periodic labor survey. In future, it will be extended to other areas of surveys also. We have recently amended the Collection of Statistics Act 2017. Earlier, the state of Jammu and Kashmir, it was not included in the collection of data from that state. Now we placed that bill before the parliament. Lok Sabha has approved it, Rajya Sabha had to approve it. And a revision of advance release of calendar of GDP, that is one of the important area, because now the budget has been advanced, and to suit that budgetary requirements, we have the calendar has been already released.
You've given quite a few achievements. If we just look at the economic survey that you talked about, what are the key advantages of this?
Economic survey, the quarterly changes in various statistical indicators in the labor market. That is, today the employment generation is one of the main objective of this government. So this periodic economic census practically it gives an idea how more and more employment generations could be done, how these establishments can be geared up. So today unemployment is one of the challenges that is being faced by the whole country. For that reason, we are making use of this economic census, sixth economic census, to create more employment, to generate more establishments and all.
So you also mentioned about the periodical revision of base year. Now it has been done for CPI as well as for GDP, etc. But what about IIP? What's the status for the base year revision of IIP?
The new series of IIP with the base year of 2011-12 has been taken, and for that the latest figures as the new series with the base year of 2011-12.
To what extent is the data that you provide, all this, the statistics, used in the budgetary process in our country?
See, almost all, in all the areas, the statistics, the real-time data is collected by the states. And even it was disseminated and complied, so that the finance department is making use of all these data while preparing that budgetary statements. Even RBI is also making use of this to calculate the per capita income and other sources, so that in which area we have to give more importance will be given by this.
So there are two main statistical divisions, the CSO and the NSSO. Now we know that the CSO does a lot on the economic side, and the NSSO, it has the sample survey of diverse fields. It tells us about the nature of the problems of our country. How effective has this been in helping us understand the challenges before our country?
Totally, the sample survey. Of course, the nodal ministries will have the full data with themselves. We will have a sample survey wherein it is today. Now we are going for a survey wherein the one family, how much they are spending for health, for education, and other areas of. So it gives a clear picture in which areas the government need to give more importance and where we have to take up the issues in the right direction. This surveys will certainly, we are doing the surveys once in 3 years, 4 years, like that, because we don't have sufficient funding and infrastructure so that to do it every year. But whenever these surveys are required by the government in certain areas, so automatically we will take up that issue and we will go ahead.
So currently the 75th NSS is being done. I think it's this year, sir.
Yes.
So what exactly are we focusing on in this national sample survey, sir?
Actually, the sample survey, wherein the 75th round that we are going to have for one full year, this year we are going to have, where we are calculating the expenditure of each family with regard to health, education, and their routine consumption items which they are.
So what are some of the publications brought out by the Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation, and how digitally accessible are they?
Every time, soon after the completion of our surveys and a collection of data, the ministry brings out a number of regular and ad hoc publications, either in the printed form or in through web releases and all that. This includes publications related to gender, elderly, energy statistics, national accounts, so many things we are doing it. Since last September 2015 up to March, we have released about 13 publications which are in our website concerning all these areas. Of course, as far as certain areas where we need to take care of, that will be immediately published soon after the surveys.
So they are all digitally published as well?
They are all digitally published. Now digitalization is one of the core areas of concern of this government. So digital movie is one of the important things that we are taking up now.
Yes, speaking of digital, sir, we are in a less cash economy, and Aadhaar-based benefits, digital economy, etc. There's so much data out there. To what extent is that going to help this statistics department, because that data can also be utilized?
The data generated as a byproduct of administrative activities. These are very important source of for decision making and all that. For example, the direct benefit transfer. Today the government is making on direct benefit transfer has constituted significantly. It has reduced the corruption and achieving the objective within very short span of time. So this digital movements has given strength to the government in eradicating corruption and other things, especially Aadhaar-based benefits and digital economy. This both goes together. So today this data, extensive data sets are being collected by our department, and digitalizing has given a moral boost to the government in administrative reforms.
We're going to take a short break. We are talking to the Minister for Statistics and Program Implementation, Mr. D.V. Sadananda Gowda, on the 3 years of the Modi-led government at the center. After the break, we'll talk about the program implementation side of this ministry. Stay with us.
Jaise jahaz ho या कैसे किसान, सारे देश का इंजन हम ही तो चलाते हैं. HP Lubricants, A-Z आपके काम आते हैं.
सफलता के लिए चाहिए बंधनों से मुक्ति.
GST देश भर में उत्पादों के बाधा रहित प्रवाह और व्यापार की सुगमता के लिए.
GST, एक राष्ट्र एक कर एक बाजार.
ई शॉपिंग साइट पर श्वेता ने देखा एक सुंदर हार. उसका डिजाइन देखकर हो गई वो बेकरार. झटपट उसने बुक किया और एडवांस में पेमेंट किया. लेकिन ये क्या, ये नहीं था वो हार जिससे श्वेता को हुआ था प्यार. शॉपिंग साइट के इस व्यवहार से श्वेता तो हुई हैरान परेशान. आप भी शॉपिंग साइट से खरीदारी करते समय रहें सावधान. जाने उनके नियमों को, टर्म्स एंड कंडीशंस का रखें ध्यान. जागो ग्राहक जागो.
प्रधानमंत्री ग्राम सड़क योजना ने हम गाँव वालों के लिए तरक्की के रास्ते खोल दिए.
सड़क के गड्ढों की फोटो खींच रहे हो, कोई खास बात है क्या?
अरे काका, मेरे मोबाइल फोन में मेरी सड़क ऐप है, जिससे प्रधानमंत्री ग्राम सड़क से जुड़ी कोई भी जानकारी सरकार तक भेजी जा सकती है। सड़क से जुड़े सुझाव या शिकायत पर सरकार वाजिब कार्यवाही करती है।
प्रधानमंत्री ग्राम सड़क से जुड़ी कोई भी बात, मेरी सड़क एंड्रॉइड ऐप अब हर पल मेरे साथ।
सुपर बाइक से लेकर ट्रक तक सब दौड़ाते हैं, सारे देश का इंजन हम ही तो चलाते हैं। HP Lubricants A to Z आपके काम आते हैं।
ये है मास्टर राजू, पढ़ाई लिखाई में कमजोर और खेल कूद के मैदान में पीछे। राजू की कमजोरी की वजह है उसका भोजन। राजू की माँ खाने में इस्तेमाल करती है साधारण नमक। डॉक्टर बताते हैं कि आयोडीन की कमी से बच्चे के शारीरिक और मानसिक विकास में बाधा पहुँचती है, इसलिए आज ही अपनाएं शक्ति और बुद्धि का रक्षक आयोडीन नमक। एक व्यक्ति के लिए आयोडीन नमक का मासिक खर्च एक कप चाय की कीमत से भी कम बैठता है।
सवारी जिंदगी, चुटकी भर नमक, आयोडीन नमक।
वेलकम बैक। सो बिफोर द ब्रेक वी स्पोक अबाउट स्टैटिस्टिक्स, नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट प्रोग्राम इम्प्लीमेंटेशन विंग ऑफ योर मिनिस्ट्री। व्हाट डज दिस एक्चुअली डू सर?
सर, दिस प्रोग्राम इम्प्लीमेंटेशन हैज गॉट थ्री विंग्स। दैट इज वन with regard to infrastructure and project monitoring division. The second one is member of parliament local area development scheme. The third one is the 20 point program scheme. Practically, the infrastructure and project monitoring division, that is IPMD, it monitors the central sector projects costing more than rupees 150 crore and above, with respect to time and cost overrun through their online monitoring software, which is called online computerized monitoring system. We collect the data from the nodal ministry, who are the implementing agency. From there, we will collect the real data through our computerized monitoring system, and we will calculate the time overrun, cost overrun, all these things, and we will suggest them how to reduce all those. Either it should be completed within the stipulated period, and why the cost overrun, how it can be. Even we are taking up this issue with the states, where the states are also need to give cooperation for the implementing of projects. Certain occasions, the state government has to give the land. So we are doing the coordinating, just like a coordinator. We sit with the state governments and with the nodal ministry of the central government, and we will assist them in completing the project within the stipulated period. Right. That is one. The second one is MP lads. That is, each MP is given 5 crore rupees per year. It provides a mechanism for the member of the parliament for creation of some durable assets based on the local needs. So, of course, the amount is only 5 crore, but still it gives a wide range of necessary things which the local people. We are just monitoring. Practically, the implementing agency is the district authority. And actually, the list has to be given by the local MP. The state government has got their own policies and guidelines. On that basis, it will be. We are releasing the funds after getting the audit report, after whether it is properly utilized or not. So we are monitoring and we are releasing the funds to the district authorities, where it will be spent by the district authority on the advice of the local MP. This is the second one. The third one is 20-point program. Practically, it was revised in 2006. It was started in 1975. Practically, it is to eradicate the poverty and improve the quality of life of the poor. So there are certain parameters where we are looking at it, how that parameters are taken care of by the state governments and how these points are implemented. These are the three areas where program implementation is being monitored by my department.
So the MP lads, how has it changed in recent years, sir?
Sir, recently, whenever we get some feedback from the member of parliament, There are two committees. One is Rajya Sabha committee, another is Lok Sabha committee to supervise and look into the matters of this MP lads. Whenever we get some suggestions from them, whenever we get suggestions from the stakeholders and all that, time and again, which suits the need of the hour, we used to change the policies. Recently, several changes have been made to suit how this funds can be given for Wi-Fi. For digital India, it is the need of the hour. So MP says that, yes, we should be given an opportunity to spend. So we are doing it. Skill development. For skill development, certain requirements are there for establishment of a skill development center and all that. So time and again, it is being revised according to the needs of the...
So what about the citizens? How does the citizen relate to the MP lad? Is it citizen friendly? I mean, in that way.
Certainly, we have got a website. That portal, anybody can go into the portal and can see how the funds are being utilized by the local MP, how it was really implemented in the ground level and all that. So practically, that web portal gives a clear picture and it is very transparent.
You did mention about infrastructure projects, sir, and of course we are an economy that has to grow fast. Infrastructure is a very crucial sector and there are many big projects that are being undertaken. How important is this, the scheme of monitoring, because even the Prime Minister monitors all these schemes very diligently, sir?
So practically, we are giving a feedback even to the PMO also. So all the data are being collected from the nodal ministry only. They are the implementing. But we are collecting and we are giving why it has been taken so much of time, the cost overrun and time overrun, what all things are there. So a real data will be given to the PMO also. During Pragati also, this data is being made use of by the Prime Minister to see that the programs and our projects are implemented in time.
So what about India's role in sustainable development goals? And your ministry is involved with that too as well, isn't it,
yeah,
sir?
Prime Minister has gone beyond the sustainable development goals. Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas. You have seen the Prime Minister has said that housing for all, education for all, health for all these things, these are all under the sustainable development goals. But our Prime Minister has already initiated several programs which already given under the sustainable development goals. Of course, as we are one of the signatories for the sustainable development agenda, we are taking care of all those things. We are evaluating how it is being worked out. Recently in the parliament also, there was elaborate discussions with regarding to health sector, which is one of the agendas in the sustainable development goals. We are taking care of all those things. And we are, once in 3 months, we are evaluating how it is being progressed across the country.
So what are the recent initiatives of the Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation on the multilateral arena, sir, multilateral forum?
Recently, we have organized that 8th meeting of heads of nations of statistical officer of BRICS that was conducted in Rajasthan on 3rd and 4th November 2016. And eighth meeting of heads of SARC statistical organization that was conducted on August 2016 at New Delhi. Now again, we are going to hold a meeting of Orberg group to exchange the ideas of strengthening generation of service sector statistics. That is that will be hosted by our country, I think by the end of September, we are going to host that. And even the Chief Statistician of India, he has co-chaired the Friends of Chair group meeting on 47th session of United Nations Statistics Commission in New York on March 2016. So almost all the international forums we are participating and we are getting ideas from various corners, exchange of our ideas with the other countries. We are doing all these activities regularly.
So finally, this ministry is a very technical ministry and it requires a lot of technical skills. How do you retain the best talent in this field And you know, how do you train it in fact?
See, practically our officers are being recruited by UPSC and SSC, Staff Selection Committee. So all these selections will be made on the capacity and ability will be checked during the appointment itself. There is extensive training is being given by the department. We have got one National Statistical System Training Academy of the ministry. It is one of the premier institute where we regularly train our staff, which suits the changing scenario of the whole country. So even from the, we used to have a mutual exchange of ideas with the international forums also. So all these staffs are being properly trained to suit, because as you rightly said, it is totally based on a technical experience. So technical experts are being often invited to give a briefing to our staff, and they are trained properly so that our total statistical system should work well, so that it should be widely accepted by the people of the country, by the countries across the world.
Indian Statistical Institute also comes under this ministry, right?
Yes.
Now, practically, it is an autonomous body. Actually, we are having all. Not only we are working not only on your mathematics and computer science, we are covering other areas also. We have got several colleges in Calcutta, Bangalore and all that, wherein the statisticians are being trained, and even that course, it nowadays gains more and more importance nowadays.
Mr. D.V. Sadananda Gowda, thank you very much for talking to us here on DD
thank
News.
You.
Thank you,
thank sir. You, thank you.